Okay, let's move across the mixer into the program out area, specifically now looking at the downstream keyer. A downstream keyer is, like the word says, it is sits downstream from all the video sources. So essentially it's another layer that can sit on top of your AB mix engine. When we look at this, we can see that there's a background section. That is what is, in fact, in the background layer. That can come from your AB mix engine or inputs 6 or 7. If you recall from the back panel, input 7 and 8 can be a PC input or it can be an S-Video input. The foreground, again, is just that. It sits in front of the background and you can pull any of your sources from AB mix or inputs 7 or 8. Now in the next few minutes we're going to look at a few applications that show you how you can use the DSK mixed with the AB out. The first one is a typical corporate presentation where you have a static screen up in a room or a theater area and you want to take a record feed of what happens during that particular meeting or event. You can't just take a record feed off what's being sent to the projector because often it's just PowerPoint or Keynote or some presentation software and you just end up having an hour or two of static slides up on the record feed. So you can set up a couple cameras like we have in number 1 and 2 source here and that can go on the AB mix to your DVD recorder, for example. And there you can take shots of the room and mix back and forth between your camera feeds. At the same time, you can send your PC or your Mac directly to the program out, as we have here. You can see on the room screen, we have some revenue growth slide here. If I do want to send my cameras to that room screen to get maybe a close-up of the presenter himself or herself, then I can just turn off that and it can then in the background assume the inputs that are coming already from your AB mix. If I want it back on again, I just hit the button and I can return. So great for those corporate presentations where you want a record feed of cameras and a static display going to the projector in the room. The next example we want to show you is where you want to have lyrics or graphics up and mix video sources underneath. This is very typical for churches, worship services, even some interviews, perhaps when a person's being interviewed and their name pops up in the bottom part of the screen. The way we've got it set up here is a couple cameras on inputs 1 and 2. As you can see, I can mix between those very easily. Now I want to lay graphics over top of those sources. This is where we have the computer that's running any kind of presentation software of your choice through into channel number 8 on the LVS800 here. You can see the background then is whatever's coming out of our AB mix engine and the foreground is coming from our computer. All we do is take it and it pops up and the key level is important. As you see, when I turn that down, the image behind disappears and as I turn it back up again, it comes into play. And that just tells the LVS800 where to make the black transparent, essentially. So we've set this up as a black Luma key, and now we're able to mix underneath the lyrics as they come up, as well as being able to select essentially any source we want. At the same time, we can go back to our computer here, and when we go to the next slide, you can see it just cycles through just like it would a normal presentation. So it's a great way and a great application to have those graphics static and secure while you're mixing underneath. Now let's look at an application where we're using multiple screens. It could be in a church or worship application or corporate presentation where you have a left and a right screen that shows camera images and a center screen that's focusing on perhaps a presentation or in the case of a worship service, maybe some abstract type of footage. For our left and right screens, we have a couple cameras here and those can switch through our AB mix output between whatever cameras or sources we have there. On the center screen, this is where our program out bus comes into play and this is currently set to input 7. In our setup here today, we have input 7 as the P10 visual sampler. This is a great product that allows you to quickly call up any video clips or still images. We have a number of loaded here. I can quickly turn to any number of types of inputs there to bring up on the center screen. In this case, if I now want to add lyrics on top of that center screen, I've got the foreground set to input 8, where we still have our PC connected, and I just take the downstream keyer and the lyrics come up over top. I can quickly move back to whatever background I want in the center screen. So here's a great application where you can have three screens, a left and a right, showing live images, as well as a center screen to display center, abstract material, and lyrics, lower thirds, whatever you're in need of. In our next example, we want to show you the chroma key function. This is very popular to use in news programs and school news shows. The way we have the mixer set up right now is a student in front of a green screen in input number 7. What we have is a map background that we want to underlay her in that image. And as well, we have a school logo to show in the corner. So three different elements we want to combine together. So first of all, let's create the background, the map playing there. We'll turn on picture in picture here, fade in the logo you can see in the upper left corner. We move over to our downstream keyer now. We set the background to the AB mix. So whatever we're seeing there is the background, and our student is in input number 7, as we mentioned earlier. That's a camera set on her just in front of a green screen. We set the key on and she appears. You can notice here in the key level, as I turn this dial down, you can see the green halo starting to appear around her. And that is just the LVS 800 training on that particular color green. As we turn it up, we can pretty well eliminate that edge around her. And you've got a great combination of three layers. The student in front of the screen, overlaid on a map, with the school logo there on the left. A great application for those morning school news programs. In all these examples that we've looked at, one of the great features the LVS 800 has is the panel preset area. If I like this particular setup that we just finished looking at, I just hold down the panel preset button until they all flash, and that exact configuration has now been saved into memory. If I jump back to another one, you see a different view. If I want to jump right back to that chroma key with the student with the logo in the background, I can just hit number 6. You can see it just pops right back up on the screen. So as you can see, the LVS 800 is quite powerful in its features, whether it be the panel preset ability to store and recall configurations very quickly, the 8 channels, the downstream keyer, the 2 computer inputs, or what we're most excited about is these 2 independent outputs, whether it be to multi-screen environments or to a record feed that's separate to the main room screen. Whatever the feature may be, it fits so many different applications at a very good price, whether it be the school, whether it be your church, your corporation, your production company, wherever it may be, this LVS 800 is no doubt one of the most powerful and innovative standard definition mixers available today. Thank you.